Well, Stephen Scott once had a boss who told him that he would never be a success. For a time, that boss was right. Steve went through 9 jobs in the 6 years after college, but one day he was challenged to read through the book of Proverbs. And within just a few years, Steve became a success far beyond his imagination. Now he is the author of an amazing book, The Greatest Words Ever Spoken, Everything Jesus Said About You, Your Life, and Everything Else. And we'd like to welcome him to the 700 Club. Great to have you
here. Thank you, Terry.
What a wonderful endeavor, and now available to all of us. Your success really started with reading the book of Proverbs.
Right.
How did that change your life?
Oh, well, you know what? I couldn't succeed no matter how hard I tried. And Gary Smalley was my best friend at the time, still is. And this is in 1974. And I said, Gary, I don't understand what's going on. And he challenged me to read a chapter a day of Proverbs with pencil and paper in hand. And as I did, I saw these incredible principles and strategies, began to apply them to business. And by job number 10, they all came into focus, and we built more than 2 dozen companies doing billions of dollars in sales on the book of Proverbs, basically on those principles.
Well, this book is entitled The Greatest Words Ever Spoken. I mean, Christians know that there's power
right.
in the Word of God. Then how much more power in the very things that Jesus himself said? What motivated you to write this?
Well, in Matthew 7, where Jesus says, many will say unto me on that day, Lord, Lord, and he gives this terrifying glimpse of judgment, you know, and he says, I'll declare unto them, I never knew you. But the very next word, which I never seen in all my Bible study, is in the next paragraph. And he says, therefore, he who hears these sayings of mine and does them, I'll liken him to the wise man who built his house on the rock.
Wow.
And I realized that what he was telling me to do, that my behavior and my beliefs, my doctrine, should all start with what he said on any given subject. But to do that, for me, I needed to organize them into topics. So what we did, we took the 1,900 statements that he made in the New Testament and organized them into about 220 topics.
I love it. It's so usable. It's so easy to find what it is you're looking for, and so powerful when you find it. Here you started out studying Proverbs.
Right.
Then your latest work is Everything That Jesus Had to Say. Were there any similarities between what Solomon had to say and what Jesus had to say?
Well, they're both the Word of God. They're both come right from the heart and mind of God. But Jesus made 15 promises about the words that he spoke on earth that he didn't make about the Word of God in general. For example, my wife and I recently went through a life-threatening situation with one of our children. Mm. So we turned to the topic anxiety, worry, and fear. And in front of us, we had every statement, 4 pages of what he said on that subject. And as we read them, I watched my wife's spirit go from this
anxiety.
To all of a sudden this tremendous peace came upon her. For me as the dad and husband, direction. And the Lord just worked miraculously in the days that followed because we really had what his words. And he said, now think about how worried people are today.
Yes.
Okay. And how people get drained and they go, oh, I don't have any life. I just feel all the energy zapped up. But he said, my words are spirit and life. And as we get into his words, Gary Smalley, the first time he read a topic in this, he started crying. Mm. And I said, Gary, what's wrong? And he said, Steve, even though I've read all these verses before, I've never read anything so powerful.
Yeah.
And we figured out, it's as if you ask the Lord, Lord, tell me about, and then he tells you every single thing he said on that subject that was recorded in one moment. So it just creates this intimacy and power and direction for us that is really unique. I mean, the
yes.
people that are using it now, God is just blessing in a real amazing way. But he made these wonderful promises about the words he spoke on earth.
All the things that we are all looking for are contained in the words that Jesus spoke.
Amen.
Stephen Scott, thank you for being with us today.
Thank you,
it's an awesome work and great to meet you.
Thank you.
And I want you to know the book is called The Greatest Words Ever Spoken, Everything Jesus Said About You, Your Life, and Everything Else. And this book is available nationwide. Every Christian ought to have a copy of this. Pat?
It sounds like a great treasure. He talks about it. I think everybody says, I want a copy. That's too good to miss. So, wherever books are sold. We leave you today with these words from Jeremiah 29. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. For Lee, Terry, and all of us, this is Pat Robertson. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.